It's very easy to look at anyone in a spotlight or anyone that's gotten to a high level and think that they just got there and it was easy and they didn't have to go through things that you might be going through, and they did just skip to the end because somebody handed it to them on a platter. And so that's something that's motivated me to always be very vocal about the things I've had to go through and overcome and my struggles and things, because most people don't ever get to see that. You know, it's very rare that gets highlighted. You know, it's like you got to realize what you're viewing is like 1% of this person's journey.
So yesterday I published on Instagram basically a picture. It was like, get started where you can, you know, don't wait for things to fall into place. And I couldn't have a more perfect metaphor than coming out of my house this morning and waking up to my wing mirror being smashed. So in good old fashion, we start with what we have. I had some masking tape in the back of the van, and I've taped the wing mirror. I've taped the wing mirror back onto the van so that we can get started on our journey today. Hello, first and foremost, I'd like to introduce you guys to today's vlog. I'm Benny. I know I introduce myself in every vlog. One of you guys actually commented and said, you know me already, why do I keep on introducing myself? And one of the main reasons is because hopefully there's new viewers tuning in, and I don't want anybody to miss out on any information. So the first thing, before we get into today's vlog, I just want to let you guys know why we are pushing these vlogs and why we're putting out this content. And one of the main reasons is for any cause to help to drive and bring awareness to any cause that we're a part of. And right now, we're driving to raise as much money as possible for a young warrior called Desmina, who's suffering from stage 4 neuroblastoma, which is a form of cancer. So hopefully through these means, we can help to drive more awareness for this cause. Now, you can check our online store, and 100% of the profits from everything we sell on our store go to this young warrior, Desmina. And you can also feel free, sorry about the noise in the background, I'm picking up stock for the store today, but you can also feel free to check out our donations page at www.johnnybangriley.com/Desmina's fund, where you can donate money directly to Desmina and her family. So hopefully through these means we can work together and drive to raise as much awareness and money as possible for this young warrior, because she deserves a break. And now I'm going to get into today's vlog, and we'll see what happens and see how the day unfolds. Everybody have a blessed day. Try life. Us. All right. Second or third time, always lucky. Come on, old Betty. Right, we're ready to go. Now, the sun is shining today, man. The weather is actually starting to feel very radiant and bright. And I'm starting to feel, this unusual feeling, which is the warmth of the sunshine on my skin. And I mean, they're saying that it's going to be another kind of cold spell here in London. I don't know if you saw one of the previous vlogs a couple of weeks ago. It actually snowed here in what is meant to be our spring, but weather is looking positive here at the moment. And I suppose one of the drawbacks for me is now I start to get hay fever. I think I'm allergic to tree pollen. I've kind of researched it and googled it, and I'll let you guys, you know, as the vlogs come on, let you know how, if you guys suffer from hay fever at all, what my coping mechanisms are and how I treat it using natural, non-drowsy, not these kind of tablet form chemicals that you can buy off the shelf. And hopefully guys, you can try it out and let me know, give me your feedback. Other than that, what's the plan today? There's going to be hopefully a lot of exciting things this week in the vlogs, because I planned a lot of content with people that I feel, you know, really represent the US philosophy, which is to never give up, persevere, face your fears, and to push through, be original, innovative, and I suppose creative, you know, despite any so-called limitations that you might have in your life. So today's vlog, I didn't really plan much content, but I do think there will be some valuable parts of the day which I'll try to share with you guys. So anyway, let's get to today's day and we'll see what happens. Puss. I try to see between the lines. I try not to keep the spirit confined. Let it feel sunshine. The van's getting a bit ridiculous now. You can see the graffiti all along the side here. I've even got a custom piece by someone that done the other day. It's a jerk on the side here as well. And on the back here, somebody's completely kind of just abused the van. So anybody out there that's any good at street art that wants to do a mural on the van and is based in London, hit us up in the comments, let me know. I really want to get this sorted out ASAP. This is crazy. I didn't even know the time today, right? And behind me, it's like 2:30 on the dot. And my phone ran out of battery. And I was like, I need to get here back here by 2:30. And as I just walked through the door, I'm like, yo, time in. So, let me turn the radio off. This is the, I suppose, the moment, the time of the day. Which, let me turn the light off in here. Which I kind of enjoyed the end process, but like I enjoyed the end result, but I'm trying to learn to enjoy the process a lot more because I'm so slow when it comes to editing. It takes me ages to edit the vlogs, it takes me ages to edit all the films and stuff. However, it shouldn't. I'm putting together a block, so I kind of got a block together and stuff to make it a little bit easier. However, it does take me a hell of a lot of time. So today I kind of set a target for the narrative. When will the narrative and everything be finished by, which was 2:30. And now the next thing for me to do, I'm going to set a timer and I'm going to edit this vlog within a certain time frame. And if I hopefully can achieve this, then I will keep on pushing it every time, every new vlog that comes out, and try and get faster and faster and editing these vlogs. But now what I'm going to do is I'm going to run you through kind of, I wanted to briefly mention just some, I'm going to do a whole vlog I think dedicated to adaptogens, which are things that help you to have clarity and focus, or for herbs and things that allow you to I suppose stay on top of your daily tasks, stay focused, have a clear mind, reduce stress and all these types of things. But one of the things I use as a kind of adaptogen for training is two things. I use matcha tea, ceremonial matcha, and I use Ruby Gabba. So I wouldn't usually have matcha and GABA in the evening because it's going to have me wired. However, just to kind of show you guys what I do pre-workout, I thought I would give you a little bit of information. Now, matcha, you know, you can Google the benefits of matcha. Try and get a ceremonial grade matcha, which means it's coarser and finer and better quality. And also try and get something that's being radiation tested as well, because you don't want to have anything that further contaminates your body. But what matcha does is basically increases your energy. It's a powerful immune system booster, enhances your mood, and also it's a very powerful antioxidant. So usually in the morning, first thing in the morning, it's good to move and exercise on an empty stomach. But I have a little shot of matcha and I have it with my Ruby Gabba. Now what Ruby Gabba is a mood enhancer also, and it contains theanine. You can Google the benefits of theanine, and it's a powerful neurotransmitter. And what the matcha does is it lifts your energy, and the Ruby Gabba just has you on a level, like clean sailing. So you don't feel that stress, and you don't, your body doesn't succumb to that stress through exercise and overexerting your body and moving. So that's how I usually start training. Again, I don't advise you to drink this in the evening because it will have you wired. But for the sake of showing you guys how I prepare myself for training, I'm going to do it.
We can do all kinds of physical things, trying to find that peace that the world is seeking, but it will still be elusive, because everything that is physical is transitory, and the only thing that is not transitory in man is his own soul.
I try to see between the lines, I try not to